Yep, almost there. Yeah, a little to the left, almost perfect. Oh, hey, fellow scientists. Oh, sorry, I guess I am running a little late for our lesson, but it's an exciting day at the Justin residence. I'm getting solar panels installed on my roof. I'm trying to make an effort to use more renewable resources in my daily life. I just have one question. What is it exactly that makes a resource renewable or non-renewable? Well, by the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain the difference between renewable and non-renewable resources and identify examples of each. Let's get into it. In our previous lesson, we learned that natural resources come from the Earth and are such a huge part of our everyday lives. Natural resources fall into two main categories, renewable and non-renewable. A renewable resource is a natural resource that will not run out because it's naturally replenished or replaced over a short period of time. Can you think of a natural resource that fits in this category? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. One of our most critical renewable resources is the sun. The energy from the sun heats our planet, and as we learned in our lessons on food chains and webs, it provides energy to almost every ecosystem on Earth. Energy from the sun is a renewable resource because it's constantly being replaced. The sun will continue to emit light and heat energy for billions of years. And as long as the sun is heating our planet, we'll also have wind, another key renewable resource. Wind is caused by differences in temperature in the atmosphere, a result of the constant heating and cooling that happens during the day and night. Because of this, wind is constantly being generated, allowing us to use it to do tasks like turning windmills and turbines. Other resources are renewable because natural processes replace their supply as they're used. For example, animals that we eat for energy, such as fish, are a renewable resource. As we remove fish from the population to be eaten, more fish are born, replacing those that are removed. The population is replenished. Trees are another extremely important renewable resource. We use trees for everything from building materials to cardboard to toilet paper. Trees are even used as a source of rubber, medicine, and gum. We can ensure this important resource is renewable by replacing the trees we harvest with new trees and forests. While many natural resources are renewable because they can be replaced as they're used, like animals and trees, others are renewable because their supply naturally cycles, like air and water. The nitrogen, oxygen, and carbon dioxide in the air each cycle through the world's ecosystems, being used and replaced back into the air. Similarly, water goes through the water cycle, continuously evaporating, condensing, and precipitating. Replacing renewable resources and waiting for renewable resources to naturally cycle does take time, but not an extreme amount. They happen regularly and frequently enough to ensure these resources keep getting replenished. So, renewable resources are ones that can be replenished relatively quickly. On the flip side, there are non-renewable resources. A non-renewable resource is a natural resource that will not be replenished in our lifetimes or even in many, many human lifetimes. Because non-renewable resources are used faster than they're replenished, there is a risk of them running out. Ore is an example of a non-renewable resource. It contains valuable minerals such as copper, gold, and iron, which are used in making everything from jewelry to electronics to money and more. However, this ore is formed through the rock cycle, which is a process that can take thousands to millions of years. This makes it a non-renewable resource. Often when we're talking about non-renewable resources, we're referring to fossil fuels. These are things like coal, oil, and natural gas that formed from the remains of organisms that lived millions of years ago. Under extreme temperature and pressure, these remains became fossil fuels. The energy from fossil fuels is what powers much of our world. We use fossil fuels to generate electricity, to fuel vehicles, to produce plastics and other chemicals, and to do so, so much more. But these resources are being used up much more quickly than new ones can form. That's why they're non-renewable. Fossil fuels aren't our only options for energy, though. Energy can be produced using renewable resources, too. The energy from the sun, wind, and the flow of water can all be used to produce electricity using solar panels like the ones I'm installing on my house, wind turbines, and hydropower technology. These renewable energy sources are more sustainable than burning fossil fuels, and they produce less pollution, too. But just like every other kind of resource, there are challenges to using renewable energy sources too. Can you think of what problems we might face in collecting solar, wind, or hydropower? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Solar and wind energy are both weather dependent, meaning they produce less energy on cloudy or windless days. Hydropower requires dams to generate electricity, which can disrupt ecosystems. Despite the challenges of renewable energy, scientists and engineers all over the world are working tirelessly to improve these technologies. They're developing more efficient solar panels, better energy storage solutions, less harmful ways of harnessing hydropower, and more solutions that we probably haven't even thought of yet. Fortunately, renewable resources are constantly being replenished. However, it does depend on how they're being used. Human actions like overfishing, deforestation, and pollution can limit our access to these resources and have a huge effect on ecosystems across the globe. That's why it's so important to use our resources sustainably, which we'll learn all about in our next lesson. Our world is constantly changing, and our understanding of both renewable and non-renewable resources is a big part of that. So let's review everything we've learned today. A renewable resource is a natural resource that will not run out because it's replenished or replaced as it's used. This includes resources like sunlight, animals, and water. A non-renewable resource is a natural resource that is not replenished within a human lifetime, and so is at risk of running out. Fossil fuels like coal, oil, and natural gas are non-renewable resources. Whether renewable or non-renewable, it's important that we use our natural resources wisely. To learn more about renewable and non-renewable resources, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. The work never stops, fellow scientists. Every day we continue to learn more about how to wisely use our natural resources. Who knows, maybe one day some of you will develop even more innovative ways to use renewable resources. But for now, I'm going to go help finish up those solar panels. I can't wait to finally be able to harness the power of the sun. Until next time, remember, science is all around us. See you next time. Hey.